Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today in this video we'll be seeing what is the KNN, that is the K nearest neighbors algorithm. So we already saw what was the naive bias classifier, and today we'll be seeing what is KNN. So KNN is basically a supervised classification algorithm in which you have some data points or data vectors which is separated into different number of several categories, and it tries to predict the classification of a new sample from that particular population set. This K nearest neighbors algorithm, that is the KNN algorithm, is a lazy algorithm. Now what I mean by lazy is that it tries to only memorizes the process, and it does not learns itself. So it's like, just consider, like, you have certain points, and if you say KNN algorithm to come here, then it will come to this point, or if you tell KNN to go there, then it will merge to that point. So it's a kind of does not take any own decisions of itself. So that's why it's a lazy algorithm. Now it classifies any new points based on a similarity measure. So that similarity measure can be like anything. You have the Euclidean distance. So it basically calculates the Euclidean distance between two points. So it's a proximity measure, and then it tries to identify who all are its neighbors. So let's understand the working of KNN. How does it works? So basically, on this axis you have some set of points. You have, that is 30 points, that is 30 vectors or 30 data points. Now some data points are labeled in black, and some are in blue, and some are in red. Now we just choose one point, that is we are interested in this point. Now we want to find the neighborhood of this particular point. Now what it does is, it basically calculates the distances from this query point to each of this current point. So these points are the current point, and this is the query point, and these all are the example points or the current points. So what this basically does is, it calculates the distances of this query point from each current point, like to this, to this, to this, to all these points, and it basically uses the Euclidean distance, or you can use any distance measure, Manhattan distance or Minkowski distance or any other distance. So it will be basically the x1 minus x2 square plus y1 minus y2 square, and it tries to have a distance matrix for all these particular data points. Now which all points are there in its neighbors, it just classifies, or that will be its particular neighbor. Now for example, say if you have k is equal to 3, then which all points which are closer to this, that is the query point, then it will label to all those as its neighbors. Now there should be two things, or you need to remember about two points about the k parameter. So the k must be an odd parameter, like 3, or it can be 5 or 7. Now why it should be odd? Because if you just assign k as any even number, like 2, 4, 6, then there will be tie in the classification of that particular label. Say for example, if there is now you have this point and you have these two points, so that there are two blue points and there are one black point. Now to which label does it assign is basically a majority scheme. So a majority voting scheme is there. So here blue wins, since there is two of the blue points and you have only one black point as its neighbor. So this point, or this query point, would be assigned the class label as blue. So blue will be the class label of this query point. Now another condition is that k must not be a multiple of the classes. So if you have, say for example, 7 classes, now then k should not be equal to 7 into 2, that is 14 classes. So this also would be a condition for the tying up of the class assignment. Now there is one particular variation, or there is one particular scenario where you have k is equal to 1. So in that case, what happens is, like, you have particular data points, then it will be assigned certain regions into the partition space. Say for example, this is into one region, and this is into one region, this is another region. So this is region 1, region 2, region 3 and region 4. So what it basically does is it partitions the space into n number of regions. So this is called as Voronoi partition space. So what it suggests is, like, if any data element that belongs to this region, or if any data point that belongs to region 1 would be assigned to this class label, that is the circle, or if there is any data element which is falling into this region, it would be assigned as this class label. Similarly, it works like that. So this is a particular scenario or a case where you have k is equal to 1. So it divides into Voronoi partition space. Now let's talk about the algorithm of KNN. How does it works? So we basically start with loading of the data. You have n number of data points. You load it from a CSV or .xls file. Then you initialize the k, that is a k is a hyperparameter in this case. So you just assign the nearest neighbors to it. That is, you will assign k is equal to 3 or k is equal to 5 or k is equal to 7, any odd numbers. That is the only one condition. Now for each of the sample in the training data, so you will be having your training data and test data. So for each data point in the training data, you have to calculate the distance between that query point and the current point. So that I've explained here, that is, this will be our query point and this will be our current point. So with any distance measure, like Euclidean or Manhattan distance, any with distance measures, you need to calculate the distance of that query point with that current point, and you have to add the distance as well as the index of the example to an ordered collection. Means there would be some collection like this, so there would be some index 0 1 2 3 4 5, and for each traversal it would assign each of the distance to each of these indexes. Now you have this ordered collection. Now you need to have a sorted collection. So for that we need to sort the ordered collection of distances and the indexes from small to large. That is, we need to sort it into ascending order, means which is the first point which is visited and which has the minimum distance from that query point. Now you need to pick the first k entries from the sorted collection. So so you have 30 points. So from the query point you would be calculating all the Euclidean distances, so that you will put into your memory or the RAM. Then with the k specified, which is here, you will pick the first that many k entries, and then you sorted them. Now you need to get the labels of the selected k entries which are there. So if it's a regression problem, then you need to return the mean of the k labels, means how many number of labels are there divided by that many labels. Or if it's a classification problem, then you need to return the mode of the k labels, and if it's k is equal to 3, then 3 will be the mode of that. So this KNN algorithm can be used with both regression as well as classification for just classifying a particular problem in supervised learning. So well, that was all regarding in this video. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you are educated watching this video, please do like, share, comment, and if you are new to this channel, please consider subscribing. Thank you very much for watching this video.